I never talk about romance series on my channel, but it's a genre that I do enjoy from time to time, but mainly keep to myself for the most part. Not because of silly reasons like being embarrassed, but because it has a hold on me whenever the stakes are as highest or when conflict arises, it tends to get to my emotions and rile me up. In short, it's not good for my health, but I still enjoy it anyway. And when you mix it together with one of my favorite genres in sports, that right there is a match made in heaven. Just when Weekly Shonen Jump were in dire need of a new romance and sports series, a new title has entered the fray that can not only fill those voids, but open up the doors towards something special. Koji Miura created a one-shot last year that after rave reviews later on gave birth to the series in Jump. Its potential is promising, we could be looking at one of Jump's newest pillars for years to come. Let's talk about Ao no Hako, aka BlueBox, and why you should consider checking out this story built around sports, love, and youth. Let's go. Before diving into my recommendation of Ao no Hako, I want to talk about my reason for being so invested in a story this early in its infancy, as I do feel that it has a good chance of having a successful run in Jump for quite a few reasons. Back in the summer of 2020, Jump had released the one-shot for Ao no Hako by Koji Miura. I had read the translation that was out for at the time and was impressed with it. It felt like something that could be in Jump and fill the sports and romance vacancies in the magazine that have now been left vacant with the departures of Haikyuu, We Never Learn, and so on. Normally most one-shots make it a series if they receive enough recognition. The momentum this one-shot got over time was staggering, and it only helped its cause with the manga comic dub that was released in the winter that saw many fans from Japan and abroad wanting to see it get serialized. And on April 11, 2021, the first chapter of Ao no Hako was released. Taiki Inomata plays on the boys' badminton team at Aomi High, a sports powerhouse. He's in love with Chinatsu Kano, who plays for the girls' basketball team. They train alongside one another every morning at the gym to improve themselves, and on one fateful spring day, their relationship takes a sharp turn, thus beginning a story of love, sports, and youth. The premise of Ao no Hako seems straight to the point, yet when you dive into the content of his first chapter, there is much more to it that makes this series potential easy to understand. Taiki has had a crush on Chinatsu for a long time, and yet they live in two completely different worlds. Taiki is someone who is at best a novice in badminton, which is seen on the lower spectrum of the sports world. Whereas in the case of Chinatsu, she plays basketball, a highly regarded sport at a level where she is seen as a future MVP for their school. Taiki understands that his current standing is nowhere close to where Chinatsu is, not just in status but the drive to become better. Chinatsu works hard every day to make her dream of going to nationals come true, and nobody knows that more than Taiki. During one of their talks together in the gym, Taiki reveals to Chinatsu the reason behind his efforts to become better. Having failed to make nationals in her last year at junior high, Chinatsu showed up the next day working on her skills while shedding tears in the empty gym alone. Taiki was the only person to see her in such a state and understood how important this was for Chinatsu, and that it would serve as his motivation to work hard towards his goals so that he doesn't have any regrets of his own. It would also be in this moment that Taiki realized that this is when he had fallen in love with her. Having been told all this by Taiki and Chinatsu being the reason behind his newfound resolve, Chinatsu was taken aback by his words. It felt that she had found someone who understood her, and because of this, she is able to find peace with herself. When it was stated that Chinatsu's family were moving abroad in the spring, Taiki realized if that were to happen, she would never be able to accomplish her goal. Because of that, he is able to make a statement that forever changes the course of his and Chinatsu's lives forever. Taiki tells Chinatsu that she has to go to nationals. She has worked too hard to see her dreams end here. Even in defeat, she must continue moving forward. She must not give up on a dream that can still be attained. Taiki is then corrected by Chinatsu that it's only her family that's moving abroad, but instead she intends to stay in Japan. She told Taiki that their conversation the other day helped her realize how much she wanted to go to nationals. The feeling of how her season ended in failure and not wanting to let that be how her career ends. And the person she has to thank for making her see the importance in all of that was the one who reminded her of it, the one who was watching over her, Taiki Inomata. Chinatsu was convinced that this was all she could accomplish, but through Taiki, she was able to rediscover her reason to keep playing and achieve the goal she set out to accomplish. Had Taiki not reminded her of that, she would have left with nothing but regrets behind. Taiki gave her the motivation to keep moving forward, as it's the very thing that made him want to work hard for his own goals because of him being inspired by Chinatsu. I view this as a crucial aspect of the story, as without it, the relationship and their motivations would not be able to have this special aura around it through any other means. They both have something they wish to achieve. One saw the end of the road but received a helping hand from the person who had noticed her and was told that she can still keep going as long as that fire is still ablaze. Without it, you can't appreciate how admirable Taiki's character is in that moment. To help out Chinatsu at her lowest point with no selfish reasons behind his sincerity, he wants her to succeed because if she were to give up now, the inspiration he got from her would be for naught. And being the pillar of strength in her time of need helped Chinatsu realize that she not only has someone who supports her, her dreams of making nationals are far from over. So all is well that ends well, Chinatsu stays at Aomi, but where is she staying if her parents are moving abroad? To which the shocking turn takes place at the end of chapter 1 as Chinatsu is staying over at Taiki's house for the next 2 years. Taiki and Chinatsu's mothers were former teammates and through their connection, Shinatsu was left in the care of Taiki's family while they went away, and now Taiki is living together with the girl he's in love with. And it's during their time together where you begin to see that they are in fact a compatible match. Just when Taiki believes there is a new dilemma to deal with in living in the same house as Shinatsu, it begins to lessen as Taiki is brought to his senses after talking with Shinatsu in his room. She realized how lucky she was that of all the people she could have been left with, she ended up with Taiki's family. To be able to have the person that she sees every morning at practice, who's willing to share a copy of Jump with her, she begins to feel at ease because she has Taiki by her side and that she's not alone. Living in someone else's home can be tough, especially if they aren't that familiar with them. Yet for Shinatsu, she had nothing to worry about because she felt that she was at home with Taiki. Taiki then realized that the only person acting like a fool was him. She's not fazed with living with another boy close to her age, so he shouldn't need to feel that way either. Taiki's love for Shinatsu is strong, and he doesn't want his selfishness to ruin what helped convince Shinatsu to stay in Japan and fight for her dreams. So instead, he decides that he wants to match her level of work ethic by making nationals in badminton. He realizes that it's going to take a lot of effort to accomplish this, but he has set his mind to not being a nuisance to the girl he loves and that he can stand by her side after working hard on his own end. Their interactions throughout the course of the series show that while Taiki is working hard on his end and at times struggles with believing in himself, something that is seen as his biggest flaw as a person, he's always being watched on by Shinatsu and that his efforts are definitely being recognized by those around him, especially from the person he loves. And in moments of hesitation where Taiki is constantly wondering about every little detail that enters his mind regarding Shinatsu, her being with other guys, or whatever she does, those things are tossed aside because at the end of the day, he's only going to end up getting sidetracked and lose focus on what he's supposed to be doing, telling himself that improving his game towards achieving his goals will keep him from having to go through overthinking about the wrong things. Something small as this from Taiki shows that this is key when it comes to relationships and keeping people together, whether it's as friends or as lovers. Without those two crucial elements, a relationship is doomed from the start. The bond that's been formed between Taiki and Shinatsu now that they're living together may have just begun, but it's already seeing early signs of hope for the two of them down the road. As long as they never forget their reasons for what brought them to where they are today, they will surely set up a long-term relationship built upon hard work, trust, and love. Especially coming off their conversation in the park at the end of Volume 1, I do think Shinatsu could be slowly becoming aware of how Taiki feels about her, although that has to be expanded upon when we get more focus on her end later on. When Taiki said it may not mean much to her about them walking home together, as it would be embarrassing for him if someone were to see Shinatsu enter his home with them, Shinatsu then comes to the realization of what he meant and the implications of that. There's then this subtle feeling around her as she says this to herself on the way home. Their interactions from then on start to see their comfortability around each other be tested, albeit in a comedic way. Shinatsu asks Taiki to bring her gym uniform to the school's rooftop, and after delivering it to her, Taiki is bewildered at seeing Shinatsu getting changed in front of him. He tells himself that she's too lax doing this with the guy around, but this could also be Shinatsu's way of telling Taiki that she trusts him enough to do this with him around. Otherwise, she would have had someone else deliver her clothes to her. Either that or she really is too relaxed and someone needs to stop her before Taiki risks it all. However, in the following chapter, Shinatsu must have realized how Taiki felt when the roles are reversed. After noticing his shirt was inside out late at night while training, Taiki proceeds to change in front of Shinatsu and her face goes completely red. And in her way of trying not to think too much about it, she comments on Taiki's body and how his physique is improving from doing strength training. But it's their talk on that night before the preliminaries is where I feel that Koji Miura has gotten a firm grasp of the story's pacing and the long-term planning for the series. Taiki is a nervous wreck in his preparation for qualifiers. He's making mistakes left and right, which is something he's never done before. This of course is because of his newfound goal in wanting to be by Shinatsu's side, both as her lover and as her equal in making nationals on his end. The stakes this time around are much higher than they've ever been. Shinatsu lends her aid in helping Taiki relax his mind by hitting his pressure point, telling him that there's no point in freaking out and that how he's feeling right now is a testament to the hard work he's put in, to go out there tomorrow and show everyone what he's made of, and that even if things don't work out now, he still has the next 2 years to make it happen. This of course leads to Taiki saying that that's not good enough. Knowing Shinatsu will be graduating by the end of her stay, Taiki has a deadline to make his dreams come true. And it's only going to motivate him even more not to make any mistakes or to be nervous. And now with the preliminaries underway, Taiki is ready to face the challenges that await him. Taiki's feelings for Shinatsu aren't overlooked either by those around him, as his friends Kyo and Hina, along with supposed rival turned teammate Haru, have taken notice. They do their best to encourage Taiki during his training to help aid him in making his dreams come true. While Kyo can be viewed as the most laid back of those associated with Taiki, he's the one that is the most aware of Taiki's crush on Shinatsu and how much it weighs on his friend's mind. He does what he can to aid him whenever they're together, despite times where he can be pretty blunt, he's the person that Taiki can be able to discuss these things with, demonstrating the level of trust between the two of them. He's also aware of Shinatsu paying attention to Taiki during his matches, almost in a way as serving as our eyes as the reader observing those around Taiki's vicinity. Despite his goals being unclear at the moment, I feel that we'll get to see more from his side as the story moves towards the qualifiers for nationals. While lacking an ability like Taiki, he may be driven to work hard just like his friend and try to make the main team. At first it was looking like Hina was going to be involved in a love triangle with Taiki and Shinatsu based on her interactions with the former, but instead, Ina has her own goal that she's currently focused on as part of Iemi's gymnastics team. Her father was once part of Japan's Olympic team, and many people believe she is Iemi's chosen one to lead them to success. Because of her status, she has to take proper care of her body to compete at the level that is required from her. She isn't good at making the effort to improve, but if she can put up with all the little things that will aid her, such as watching her weights and exercising, she'll do so. Knowing what Hina is going through to become strong on her own, Taiki acknowledges her efforts and looks at what she's doing as motivation to steal his own resolve to continue fighting for his goals. Yet from the other side, Hina finds Taiki's will to improve in hopes of winning over Chinatsu admirable. Their connection is something I found to be a great component that differs from the others that support Taiki. They are both characters that know that they have their own limitations on their path towards achieving their dreams. Yet, even then, they want to fight in their own ways to get to where they want to be. That common ground is what creates a bond that isn't meant to lead to a relationship, but rather two friends who simply want to cheer on each other to do their best and are willing to aid them on their respective paths. They also have some great comedic moments whenever they are together, which shows how good their dynamic is with one another, especially considering that they've known each other ever since their first year in junior high. When it seemed that Taiki had found a rival in Haru, who was good friends with Chinatsu and they are both in the same grade, there was a misconception in Taiki's mind that he had already lost before even trying, as he would see Haru hanging out with Chinatsu during and after school, making it seem that Haru liked Chinatsu and possibly vice versa. Yet it turns out that Haru already had someone that he liked, and Chinatsu had aided him in his efforts to impress his eventual girlfriend. Haru only has three things on his mind: badminton, his girlfriend, and Monster Hunter. And yes, that's all in order. Even if he does like to egg on Taiki for his crush on Chinatsu, he still has a more serious side to him when it comes to badminton, and later on serves as a mentor to Taiki. The match between them during their preparation for nationals depicts the newfound determination in Taiki's resolve on a broader scale. Despite being beaten and shown the difference between the two of them and their level of skill, Taiki's will to keep going and fighting back in rallies are what won him over with the coaches and with Haru. During their talk together with Haru's classmates and Chinatsu, Haru states that while Taiki lacks an ability, he believes Taiki will improve and become strong one day. This belief in Taiki and the expectations Haru has for him both surprise and impress me with his character. He doesn't put this level of effort into helping anyone that he doesn't care about, as mentioned by his friends, and it shows to me that Haru saw something in Taiki during their match and while they were practicing with each other shortly after. Not to mention, because of what Haru did, the older students took note of Taiki's efforts, and because of it, Taiki appreciates them recognizing his ability and feels more comfortable with himself. And that wouldn't be possible without Haru being involved. Due to all these factors, it's safe to say that Haru will play an integral role in Taiki's development, both as a player and as a person throughout the duration of the story. Because of these interactions that we've gotten so far from the rest of the main cast, it tells me that we won't have to worry so much on Taiki and Chinatsu being the only ones to carry the story, as Kyo, Hina, and Haru are capable of holding their own weight and can contribute when they step onto the stage. Aonohako has a lot going forward with the elements surrounding the series that appealed to me and caught my interest from the start that depict its potential. The art was one of the initial aspects that pulled me in, with how vibrant it's presented through its characters, environments, and especially during the matches, along with how it reflects the personalities of the characters so well that you can feel the emotions they give off when looking at them. And to think that Miura's drawing along with his writing will improve with each chapter has me excited to see his final product by the end. You can tell by the writing and with its pacing that Miura is taking his time fleshing out the story so that it can be displayed in the way that it was intended to be told. Everything feels carefully handled, the characters have their personalities and motivations established. There's no signs of rushing towards the finish line, which is a good sign for its longevity. In terms of what I'd like to see from Aonohako in the long term, I'd love to see the story focus a bit more from Chinatsu's perspective. As stated earlier, as the star of her basketball team, I think it would be good to follow the story from Chinatsu's point of view from time to time and see how she feels when being around Taiki, working towards making nationals, and her connection with those around her in her everyday life. Little things like that and finding out more of what goes on with her that we normally don't see would be a nice addition to the story, so that we can see how she feels with her newfound determination to achieve her dreams, her bond with Taiki, and whether she ends up taking note of his love for her. It would also allow us to freshen things up a bit so the focus isn't solely on Taiki's route alone and we get to see the other side of the story from Chinatsu's eyes. And whenever a tournament or even a big event takes place that involves one of them participating, we can see them support each other during them to strengthen the bond between the two throughout the story. I would like to see the cast start to grow gradually over time with a few more characters to be involved, not in the sense of focusing on quantity over quality, but those that are around Taiki and Chinatsu to have more of a presence as time progresses. People such as Coach Iguchi, Taiki's parents, and maybe having people from Chinatsu's basketball team get involved. Since we don't know how long this story will go on for, it's better to focus on those that will play a role in helping out our protagonists in their time of need, whether it's to do with their training or being someone that can lend an ear from time to time, which is what we've been getting so far from Kyo, Hina, and Haru. Especially when it comes to nationals, Coach Iguchi, who has been said to be keeping an eye on Taiki's progress, I think it's only a matter of time before we get to see them lend their teachings to help Taiki on his path towards nationals. And lastly, I hope we get to see Mira's knowledge of badminton in full depth and how he can make it into something interesting for non-fans that will allow others to look at the sport with a new perspective. Badminton's popularity in Japan is there, and with the Olympics on the horizon, any future success could see the sport grow even more across the country and get people of all ages to pick up a racket and try it out. With the recent rise in popularity since its debut, it's looking very likely that Aono Hako will be here to stay. It's already being well received both in Japan and overseas, and has had a few chapters trend on social media to rave reviews, not only showing that it has a growing fan base, they are here to see Koji Mira's up and coming new hit series prosper in Weekly Shonen Jump, and the constant talk about this story feels like the beginning of something special and that there are people who are here to see how far this momentum can be taken. Although Aono Hako is in its early stages, it offers plenty of excitement to Jump readers as a romance sports series that feels different from what we're used to seeing in the magazine. At first glance, you feel that it doesn't belong long and Jump, whether it's because of its art style or the fact that it's a romance series mixed in with some sports. And yet, with the past few years and the different series that come before it, some of which have saw success for standing out against the grain, the same could be said for Aono Hako if it keeps up this current trajectory. I have pretty high expectations for the story to succeed. Romance and sports series aren't new to Jump, but mixing them together in its current setting is easy to connect with readers of all ages, and it has a chance to be quite special in a magazine that is normally primed with battle manga. A story based around love and sports as a nice variety for enjoyers of both genres could give Jump more consideration in the future to serialize more titles of this ilk if Aono Hako succeeds. The long-term planning is in safe hands, and should it reach its potential, Aono Hako will be another new hit series for many years to come. Let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below regarding Aono Hako, aka BlueBox. What are your first impressions with the story so far? What do you believe is the strengths and the weaknesses to this series in both the present and the future? Do you see it having a successful run and Jump? Let me know all of that down in the comments below. Like the video if you enjoyed, subscribe to the channel if you guys are new here. If you want to see more content like this from me in the future, subscribe if you haven't already, click on the bell Shandora to stay up to date with everything that goes on the channel. And with that being said, I will catch you guys in the next video. Commodore Lad signing off. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, take care.